In the last lecture, we talk about innovation and invention, and we know that invention is which is something which is new, and the innovation is the execution or development of invention in such a way to develop a technology for the betterment of any field. So today we will talk about agriculture innovation system, that how it works and what are the requirements. So this is a kind of a basic information or basic ideas which we must have when we talk about agriculture innovation system, or when we want to bring some innovations in agriculture. So generally, when we have a research and education, so we have to get the end products, business, consumers, and the producers. So these all are relevant to whatever we earn in research and education. So these three are main parts: agribusiness, consumers, and producers. So if we have a research which is not supporting any of them, so it means so that will not be really practical. We need producers, or we need that technology friendly for the producers, friendly for the people in business, and friendly for the consumers. And for consumers, it is more important because so it also have some economic values. And also, for example, if we have some edibles and we develop a new variety, and that variety has some other taste as compared to conventional varieties, so consumer may not accept those. The economic, or maybe that new variety is expensive, but that is one factor. But even if it's not expensive, it is cheaper, the consumer may not accept it due to the variation in the taste, variation in the color. So whenever we talk any research, education, as we want to bring some innovation, we need the acceptability of that for at least for these three partners. So how can we develop this? This can only be developed when we bridge the different institutions. So we have a stakeholders. We have different stakeholders which must be consulted: extension workers, contractual arrangements. So contractual, we must hold meeting with the stakeholders, and the mainly the stakeholders are these, the people involved in that. And then the extension worker may help you, and some contractual arrangement that for any specific project or intervention, you may have some special consultants or special or experts for that, which you may not find from stakeholders or from extension workers. And this whole system is affected or is dependent on the science and technology policy, political system, science actors, the people who are really are in direct connection with science, mean the researcher, and technology from other sectors. Because the technology from other sectors may also affect the technology of agriculture, or may also support to produce a good innovation system for the development. So we can define then agriculture innovation system based on this available information, that a collaborative arrangement bringing together several organizations and individuals working towards a desired change in agriculture can be called as agriculture innovation system. So what is this desired change? desired change is dependent on these three stakeholders. What the consumer wants, what the producer wants, agribusiness, the people in agribusiness. अगर आप कोई प्रोड्यूस बना भी लेते हैं नहीं और वो बिजनेस नहीं दे रही बिजनेसमैन को तो दैट विल बी फेल्ड, तो दैट विल नॉट वर्क. सो जब हम चूंकि ज्यादा हैं कि रिसर्च प्रपोजल की तरफ हैं, वी आर टॉकिंग टू डेवलप रिसर्च प्रपोजल, इनोवेटिव रिसर्च प्रपोजल. सो अगर कोई रिसर्च प्रपोजल बिजनेस नहीं देती तो वो इफेक्टिव नहीं है. It means the funding agency will not fund that. अगर वो consumer उसको accept नहीं करते उस जो उसकी आपकी output होगी, so in that case again the funding agency will not accept. And the producers, so they will also have some desires. So we have to take care of those. And by taking care of those, when we develop some strategy, so that is basically agriculture innovation system. The perspectives using the innovation lens in analyzing critical constraints, identifying, implementing, and assessing appropriate interventions and subsequent utilization of knowledge generated. हम इसको इस तरह perceive करते हैं कि जो क्रिटिकल कंस्ट्रेंट हैं उनको एनालाइज करें कि क्रिटिकल कंस्ट्रेंट है क्या जो हमारा सिस्टम है उसके अंदर. देन जो इंटरवेंशंस हैं उनको आइडेंटिफाई करें, उनको इंप्लीमेंट करें, उनको असेस करें, क्योंकि असेसमेंट के बगैर कोई भी आप टेक्नोलॉजी अप्लाई नहीं कर सकते. एंड ultimately to utilize that knowledge, कि जो भी knowledge उससे generate हो उसकी utilization हो. तो ये हमारी perception है कि हम एक ऐसा innovation lens जो है वो उससे उसको देखें, जो भी हम नई innovation लेके आ रहे हैं, जो that can analyze the critical constraints and that can also identify the intervention and those interventions can be implemented and can be assessed. कि जब ये अगर आप पिछले जो हमने सिस्टम देखा है, अगर उसमें जो तीन कंज्यूमर्स, तीन स्टेक होल्डर्स हैं, अगर आप उनको देखें तो यू विल फाइंड सम रिलेशन ऑफ दीज वर्डिंग विद दोस. सो देर आर थ्री एलिमेंट्स for the analysis: the organizations and the actors, the relationship and the interactions, the competencies, functions and results of such interaction. So whatever we have, the components, the organization, the people involved that, and then their relationship, interactions of individuals with the institutions, institution to institution, and even the individual to individual, so that matter. And then the competency, the people and the organizations involved in that, how competent they are, how functional they are. If they are not functioning, they have competent people, but they have all the equipments, but there is a lack of functionality due to any reason, that may be political reason or any administrative reason. And results of such interaction, aur unke jo results hain jo hum interact karwa rahe hain, unki perception jo hai wo bhi zaruri hai to develop a innovation system or a successful innovation system. Innovative agriculture research for development. When we talk about that, so we have to consider two things, being considered whenever you apply for funding to the agency. So they will see at least these two major things. a new approach to help research contribute more effectively and efficiently to poverty reduction and sustainable natural resource management. So these both are very important to reduce poverty and to sustain the natural resources. So it is not only the one factor that we are increasing the productivity, but it's also important to sustain the available resources. कि हमने किसी बंदे से इतनी लड़ाई नहीं करवानी या उससे इतनी गेम नहीं खिलवानी कि वो खुद बंदा तबाह हो जाए और आपको प्रोडक्शन दे दे. आप देखें जो खिलाड़ी थोड़ा सा भी वो जख्मी होता है या उसको कोई इश्यू होता है तो उसको फौरी तौर पे वो बिठा देते हैं, हालांकि वो उस वक्त खेल सक रहा होता है. द इंजरी या उसकी एक्सटेंट इतनी नहीं होती कि वो खेल ना सके, लेकिन अगर वो खेलेगा तो वो अपना नुकसान भी करेगा साथ, तो इसलिए उसको वहां से हटा दिया जाता है. अगर आप क्रिकेट के मैचेस देखें या उसमें बाज औकात इतनी क्रिटिकल सूरत हाल होती है कि उसमें उनको नहीं हटाते, वो रिस्क लेते हैं. और वो रिस्क ये होता है कि वो उस बंदे की पर्सनल जो है इंजरी उसको होने का या उसके बढ़ने का या उसका नुकसान होने का खतरा होता है. तो वी डोंट हैव टू प्रोड्यूस फूड और वी हैव टू रिड्यूस द पॉवर्टी, बट वी हैव टू सस्टेन द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. To mainstream a new way of doing business that ensures that research does not only lead to knowledge and publication but also contributes to change and innovation for the betterment of the people while also preserving the natural resource. So the last is again repetition, but it is important again, even you are working with a very good idea for the betterment of the people, you have a great contribution coming out of that. But if your natural resource management is not preserved, so that will not be accepted. So this is the main theme which is being considered. कि जो natural resources हैं हमने उसको नहीं खराब करना. तो ये जो hard issues हैं. थ्रस्ट इसमें क्या हो सकती हैं फॉर डेवलपमेंट, सेट ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स फॉर कंडक्टिंग रिसर्च फॉर डेवलपमेंट, टू डेवलप सम प्रिंसिपल्स. जो प्रिंसिपल्स हैं वो थ्रस्ट है कि हमने जो मौजूदा सूरत हाल है उसके बेस पे जो पॉलिसी आई उन्होंने कुछ प्रिंसिपल्स जो हैं वो डिवाइस किए. ये हम नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में देखेंगे वो क्या प्रिंसिपल हैं. तो वो एक थ्रस्ट है. So we have to follow those. कुछ प्रिंसिपल ऐसे बन गए हैं कि कम्युनिटी ने बना दी है कि हमने डेवलपमेंट उन प्रिंसिपल की बेस पे करनी है. सो दैट इज आल्सो थर्स्ट बिकॉज वी हैव टू फॉलो बीइंग ए कम्युनिटी मेंबर वी हैव टू फॉलो दोस. A new research agenda that addresses interaction between natural resource management, production system and agriculture markets and policies and institutional change for new partnership involving all stakeholders in the agriculture innovation system. Because we have seen in the last slide that the natural resource management is very important, so we have to develop the interaction with the production system and the agriculture market. So these are the thrusts. The agriculture market is changing day by day, the production system are changing day by day, the reason may be the climatic effects. So these are the thrusts that we have to change the production systems as per requirement, and the agriculture we have to follow the agriculture markets. And we have to follow the policies for that. Institutional change for new partnership involving all stakeholders in agriculture. So this is also a thrust that कि जितने भी stakeholders हैं वो आपस में मिल के काम करें. There are four pillars of agriculture research development. Organizational and institutional chain, knowledge management and information sharing, capacity building, monitoring and evaluation and impact assessment. Okay, organization and in institutional chain, interaction with the institutions and organizations. The knowledge whichever is present in those organizations and the sharing of information. So when those organizations will manage their knowledge in such a way that they share their information to each other or to one another, and then the capacity building where it's missing. So if we think that there are certain pockets where the capacity building is required, so we have to do that. And then monitoring and evaluation. Whatever we are thinking, we have to monitor that. So this will give us this scenario that the outcome, which is very hard, intensifying smallholder farming because we have small land holdings, intensification is required to feed them and to make it more profitable. But with the same, at the same time, we need the sustainable natural resource management, and at the same time, developing efficient market, because the developing efficient market can contribute to sustainable nitrogen, sustainable natural resource management, because we have to manage the produce. Agar hum zyada production ki taraf jayenge, to hum natural resources ko zyada hum deteriorate karenge. Agar hum jo produce hai, uski achhi marketing ho, efficient marketing ho, wastage kam ho, so that will help. Hame utni production nahi deni padegi. For example, so it is said ki 2050 tak jo hai wo 1/3 more jo food hai wo production uski zarurat hogi. Lekin agar aap dekhen jo is waqt wastage hai, that is more than 1/3. Ki agar 10 billion agar hum 8 billion people ko feed de rahe hain, तो जो प्रोडक्शन है वो 10 बिलियन के लिए, बाकी जाया हो रही है. तो अगर हम सिर्फ उसी को मैनेज कर लें तो हमारे जो नेचुरल रिसोर्स हैं उसके ऊपर प्रेशर कम होगा. तो दैट मस्ट बी टेकन केयर. तो ये जो तीनों पार्ट हैं, दे हेल्प टू डेवलप एप्रोप्रिएट पॉलिसीज. सो दैट इज द बेस ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर रिसर्च फॉर डेवलपमेंट. So then what are the steps? For example, you have any problem in agriculture sector, there is an organizing team. So they define the system of interest, because you have a different organization, different institution, different people. They define their interest, that what can be done. Then they identify the strategies. The kaun si strategy jo hai wo ho sakti hai. Lekin इसको रीथिंक, इंटीग्रेशन मीन रीथिंकिंग, उसको बार बार करना. सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. हम कहते हैं जी वो मीटिंग्स हो रही हैं, मीटिंग्स बेसिकली ये कर रही होती है रीथिंकिंग. एंड देन फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ रिसर्च प्लान्स, बिकॉज व्हेन यू हैव प्लान द रिसर्च, सो यू हैव टू पुट सम रिसोर्सेज ऑन दैट. यू मे हैव टू वर्क on that plan for years, but if it is not formulated in a precise way, it means there is a loss of resources, there is a loss of time. So that's why it is rethinking. So this is very important, that ke ek cheez jo hai wo usko bar bar sochna, bar bar sochna. To ye science hai ye, ke jo cheez, जो आइडिया आप है उसको बार बार सोचें. अगर आप बार बार सोचेंगे, आपको उसके अंदर से कुछ चीजें निकलती नजर आएंगी. व्हेन यू आइडेंटिफाई द स्ट्रेटजीज, यू गिव अ रिपोर्ट बेसिकली. अगर जब यहां से हम जो रीथिंकिंग से हमें जो चीजें निकले, हम उसकी रिपोर्ट देनी होती है उसकी. एंड देन रिपोर्ट के बाद, अगर वो रिपोर्ट आपकी अप्रूव हो जाती है, कि बेसिक आइडिया आपका एक्सेप्ट हो जाता है, तो देन यू कैन prepare the plan, which is a research proposal. So this is all those things. लेकिन मैं शायद पहले भी आपको लेक्चर में मैंने कभी कहा हो कि साइंटिस्ट का काम ये है, ये वाला कि उन्होंने सोचना है, उन्होंने फॉर्मुलेट करनी है रिसर्च. जो एग्जीक्यूशन है दैट इज बेसिकली टेक्नीशियंस इशू. आप एक रिसर्च प्लान करते हैं, वो आप किसी को बता दें, जो पढ़ा लिखा बंदा है तो वो आपको कर देगा. कोई इक्विपमेंट चलाना है वो टेक्नीशियन, वो आपको कर देगा. तो ये रिसर्च प्रपोजल असल में साइंटिस्ट का काम है. ये रिसर्च प्लान जो है ये रिसर्च साइंटिस्ट का काम. तो इसलिए ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. जो आगे का काम है वो टेक्नीशियन भी कर सकता है. देन द वैल्यू चेन. ए वैल्यू चेन आल्सो रिक्वायर्ड इनोवेशन सिस्टम. ए वैल्यू चेन डिस्क्राइब्स द full range of activities which are required to bring about ke aap ek cheez produce karne se leke uske istemal hone tak, a product or service through the different phases of production, delivery to final consumer and final disposal after you. So whatever you produce, how you deliver it, and then the final disposal, that after use, what is your disposal, where everything is going on, even the waste material, where that goes. So ye value chain hai. Aap har cheez mein value addition kar sakte hain, yahan se leke iski production se leke iski delivery and then iski disposal, jo waste hai usme bhi aap jo hai wo income generate kar sakte hain, from hoe to fingers, from plow to fork. So these are the terms which are used sometimes when we talk about value chain. So innovation is also required for that. So if we look at the simple value chain design, produce, production, marketing. In production, you have a transformation, the packaging, marketing, processing, actual sale, and consumption and recycling. तो ये सारी वैल्यू चेन है. ये एक जर्नल है, ये सिर्फ एग्रीकल्चर के लिए नहीं है. एवरीथिंग कि आप उसको एक डिजाइन करते हैं प्लान, फिर प्रोड्यूस करते हैं, फिर उसको मार्केट करते हैं, फिर उसकी कंजम्पशन, और कंजम्पशन के बाद उसकी रिसाइकलिंग. तो दिस इज ए वैल्यू चेन. सो नाउ इन द लास्ट स्लाइड आई जस्ट वांट टू मेंशन हियर सम emerging challenges for agriculture research. So whenever you will plan your research, or you are thinking nowadays to develop and to generate an idea, so you can have help from the, for example, global financial crisis. So this is especially in this COVID era, it's very 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 prominent all over the world. Emerging food and energy crisis. Food production is not sufficient. It's not. Energy is very costly, very expensive. Greater concern for environment, because environment is changing. We don't have to pollute. We have to compromise some production to save environment. Then climate change. Then trade market liberalization. Emerging agri-food systems. जो market में changes आ रही हैं worldwide. Emerging diseases, नई नई बीमारियां आ रही हैं. Growing need for intersectoral linkages, because we have to produce in a such a way that can be marketed very easily, and that is very nutritious if it's relevant to the food. It is environment friendly, so that needs some linkages. Changing expectation from science, technology and innovations. So जब इतने मसाइल हैं तो साइंस से एक्सपेक्टेशंस भी जो चेंज हो रही है. अंडर इन्वेस्टमेंट इन एग्रीकल्चर एंड एग्रीकल्चर रिसर्च. एग्रीकल्चर रिसर्च में जो इन्वेस्टमेंट इतनी ज्यादा नहीं हो रही, उससे जो है इश्यू जनरेट हो रहे हैं. तो इसकी इन्वेस्टमेंट बढ़ाने के लिए प्रपोजल्स हो सकती हैं. Technological advances in biotechnology and information and communication technology, ICT, information and communications technology. So इसमें जो नई नई innovations आ रही हैं उसकी utility to develop the innovation system. Globalization of private agriculture research and innovation because the research is going toward the private sector. The people, they have their own research. For example, Monsanto है, अगर उन्होंने अपने research farm बनाए हैं, उन्होंने hybrid develop किए हैं और वो business कर रहे हैं. इस तरह बहुत सारे fertilizers हैं. They can private sector can do research and then they can commercialize it. तो ये अब बहुत बड़ा issue बनता है. बहुत बड़ा ये issue तो नहीं से कहना चाहिए. This is a forum. So that was all about today.